Hello children, today we will be learning chapter number 16, that is Animal World. In this chapter, we will learn about different types of animals, how they live, their behaviors, their appearances, how they protect themselves, the mutual relationship among themselves, how they continue their existence on earth by giving birth of their own kinds, and we'll also discuss why animals are humans' best friends, and we'll also tell you a story on it. As we are talking about animals, do you know that animals usually move in groups to protect themselves, to gather food and to find shelter? So their group is led by a strong, powerful and responsible leader who protects them from all the dangers and takes all the major decisions in the group. Let's study about them. A group of monkeys is called a troop. It comprises of both males and females with a mature male as a leader. There are approximately 50 to 60 monkeys in a troop. Now, elephants move in herds. The herd consists of 10 or more female elephants and their young. Their leader is usually the oldest female who takes decision and protects her herd from enemies. She is called the matriarch. The king of the jungle, the lion, too lives in groups having 8 to 10 members in it. Most of them are lionesses and only 2-3 are males. The job of the lioness is to hunt for prey and provide food to the male lions and the cubs. She also warns the pride in case of any danger. Fish swim together in thousands. At the same speed to confuse the attacker, they swim in groups called shoals. Wolves, foxes and jackals hunt in groups. Their group is called a pack. A pack usually has 6 to 7 members. Now, birds fly together in flocks. Mother and the father bird bring up their young ones together. Insects like bees, ants and termites live in group called colonies. The colony usually consists of a queen, drone and workers. There is a queen who lay eggs and is the leader of the colony. Drones are the male whose work is to help in reproduction. They are a few in number. And next, workers. Workers are thousands in number. All of them are females. They work all the time to bring food, protect their home or colony from their enemies and repair their anthill or beehive. Well, can you find the honeybees over here? So this is the structure of a beehive. And now this one is the inside of a beehive. Now let's watch a video on how honeybees make honey.
How do bees make honey?
No idea.
To make honey, the worker honeybee sucks nectar from flowers and stores it in its honey stomach. Once the worker bee returns to the hive, it vomits the nectar into a processor honeybee's mouth.
Ew!
In the processor bee's mouth and stomach, an enzyme called invertase is added to the nectar. Invertase breaks some nectar into simple sugars like glucose and fructose. Then it vomits the partially converted nectar into another processor bee's mouth, who also adds more invertase, helping break down more nectar. This process goes on until most of the nectar is converted into simple sugars. Then, the mixture of simple sugars is stored in the honeycomb. At this point, the mixture is still watery. Hence, the bees flap their wings, which evaporates water and thickens the mixture to eventually form honey.
Now, we will learn about animal behavior. Animals can be classified on the basis of their behaviors. There are some animals who are very shy and do not come near us. Like, yes, moles, rats, deer, birds and insects. But there are others who are very friendly, like dogs, cats, hens. They are very friendly to humans and they accept our food and fat. Let's learn about how animals protect themselves. Different animals have developed different methods of protecting themselves. Some of them hide themselves from their enemies, concealing themselves in burrows under rocks and leaves. Turtles hide themselves under their shells. We see a number of animals around us. Animals are of different shapes, sizes, and appearances. Can you spot the insect over here? Well, this is called camouflage, means to merge with the surroundings. There are some animals and insects who use camouflage and warning colors as the way of protecting themselves. In this picture too, can you find the chameleon over here? No, the upper part of the picture is a chameleon. So are you familiar with the picture? Animals like humans help each other in many ways. There is a special relation between one species of animals and the other. For example, a few birds sit on the back of cows or buffaloes and giraffes and oxen and eat the insects on their body and also take rest there. This in turn helps the animals to get rid of the insects and parasites from their bodies. In forest, monkeys and birds raise alarm to the alert of their fellow animals about the danger that is coming. Now, this picture says a lot. I am very afraid of seeing this picture. A bird called plover enters the mouth of a crocodile and feeds on the meat stuck in its mouth and in the process cleans the crocodile's teeth. The crocodile does not harm it. Animals are classified as mammals, insects, birds, reptiles, etc. Some animals like deer, elephants, rabbits and donkeys have big outer ears called external ears. Some others like birds and lizards do not have big outer ears. They have holes on the side of their heads. These are called internal ears. Ears help the animals to detect danger or search their prey. In some animals, they also help in regulating their body temperature. However, some animals like snake do not have ears. They feel the movement or sound through the vibration on the ground. All of them have different coverings on their body. Amphibians like frogs and toads have loose, moist skin. Reptiles like snakes and lizards have scales over their bodies. Fish also have scales all over their bodies. Birds have feathers on them, as you all know this. Mammals mostly have hair called fur on their body. Some like zebra, tiger, etc. have short hair, and the other like yak and polar bear have thick and shaggy hair. The fur is according to the climate of their habitat. It helps them control their body temperatures. Now we will discuss about a very important topic, reproduction in animals. All animals, birds and human beings produce young ones of their own kind. They either lay eggs from which babies are hatched or give birth directly to their young ones. This process is called reproduction. The process is very important because without this, species will be extinct. The animals love and take care of their babies. Animals reproduce in two ways. By laying eggs, they are called oviparous. By giving birth to babies, these are called mammals or viviparous animals. Birds, insects, reptiles and fish lay eggs. Let us have a look at the structure of an egg. The egg has a hard outer covering called a shell. The shell protects the baby inside. The developing baby inside the shell is called an embryo.
Within the shell, a white liquid called albumin is present along with a yellow colored yolk. The yolk provides food for the growing baby. All animals have a life cycle, which means there are various growth stage of an animal from the embryo to an adult. The animals like dog, cat, deer, elephant, tiger, and humans are all mammals. They give birth to their young ones directly and feed the babies on mother's milk. The mammals look after their young ones till they become adults. Animals like horse, elephant, and camel are used by humans to transport people and goods from one place to another. Animals are used by humans to research and testing. We also keep some animals as pets. They serve as companions to differently abled people. Animals such as dogs are useful in catching criminals and sometimes even save us from them. We also obtain products like leather, fur, ivory, and pearl from some animals.
Animals are called the friends of humans. They are very helpful for human beings. Animals like cow, goat, and buffalo give us milk. They are called milch animals. Sheep gives us wool. We get eggs from hen and duck. The meat of goat is eaten by humans. Honeybee gives us honey, as you have seen already. Earthworms are also the farmer's friend.
Some animals are known as beasts of burden. Let's see some such animals. Camels. Camel is the most commonly used mode of transport in a desert. It can walk easily on sand and can survive without water for days together. It is also known as the sheep of the desert. Bullocks. In villages, bullock carts are used for transportation. Yaks and mules. They are used as means of transport in hilly areas. Elephants are used mostly in jungles to carry very heavy loads. They are also used to transport people for joyrides. Horses. Horses are animals used for transport and for pleasure. They have been used in battlefield and also for working in farms. A horse is a very graceful animal known for its power and speed. It is a very essential means of transport. Horses have been used by kings to draw chariots in the battlefields. The power of a king was estimated by the number of horses he possessed. Horse carriages are used in rural areas even today. They are known as tongas or tumtums. They are still popular in cities like Agra, Lucknow, etc. Horses are also used in Indian marriages from ancient time. Horse riding is a sport and also a means of entertainment. For riding a horse comfortably, saddles are used. Horses travel in all kinds of terrain.
Now let us know the story about the famous horse Chetak.
In the 16th century AD, a king named Maharana Pratap ruled over parts of northwestern India. He had to fight many battles during his lifetime. In most of his battles, his gallant horse named Chetak fought courageously with his master and guarded his master's life. On the many battles Maharana Pratap fought, the battle of Haldihati was the most important. During the battle, the army of Rana Pratap was only 1/4 of that of the enemy. But Chetak, like his master, was not afraid. Sensing that its master's life was in danger, it took its master with great difficulty to safety, therefore away from the battleground. Chetak, in doing so, lost his life and died as one of the greatest heroes of history. Chetak's statue can be seen along with that of Maharana Pratap in various places in India.
So, we are at the end of the chapter and we have learned that
love and care are the two things animals need from us. As seen in Chetak's story, animals are very faithful to us and love and protect us. But we must make sure we also love them and take complete care of them. Domestic animals should be properly fed and kept in clean shelters. We should never tease them or be cruel to them by overburdening.